मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट चैप्टर 10 ऑफ क्लास 6, दैट इज मोशन एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ डिस्टेंस. एज वी यूज डिफरेंट मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट और डिफरेंट व्हीकल्स टू ट्रेवल फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. एज दीज व्हीकल्स आर यूज्ड बाय फॉर डिफरेंट डिस्टेंसेज. For example, if you go for a nearby market for shopping, you prefer to go by foot. So, as you see your classmates prefer to come to school by school bus, some used cycles or some came to school by walking. So, here different modes are used for the traveling from one place to another. But actually, we are not able to know about how far that place from our place. So, to understand or to answer that question, we will study in this chapter the story of vehicle and the measurement of the distances. So, the first is story of transport. In the ancient times, people preferred to go by foot instead of any vehicle. Because at that time vehicles were not discovered yet. They preferred to go by foot or they carry their goods on their back and travel long distance in ancient times. Some people use animals to travel from one place to another, or that place, if that place is far away from them, they use animals at that time. With the discoveries or with the passage of time, there were different discoveries were formed. In water, boats were used to cover the distance of water. As there is a river or oceans are there between the two places, then they prefer to go by boats. So, in ancient times, the boats were not as developed as they are seen in today's area. So, the boats are just a piece of log. Or with the certain inventions, the people used that boats that are changed or modified into certain shapes. These shapes are as resembles to the animals of the water. As you know, fish has streamlined body. So, boat also have that streamlined structure so that they can travel or move in water very easily. So, after that, in 19th century or before 19th century, the invention of wheel take place. So, with the invention of wheel, people used animal to pull cart. So, it is very helpful to cover that is long distances or carry their goods as well as. So, animals are the part of their transport. After that, the invention of steam engine take place. People use the carriages and wagons to drive that steam engine. So, at that time, automobiles, motor cars, truck and buses were used as the modes of transport. With the development of aeroplane in 19th century, they were used to carry goods as well as passengers. So, as the development take place, people use the different modes of transport or the different methods to travel from one place to another. So, at the start of 20th century or the end of 19th century, the development of aeroplane take place. But the start of 20th century, many electric trains, monorails, spacecraft, supersonic aeroplanes were used by the people to travel a long distance in their life. So, as you know, the traveling from one planet to another planet is also become easy by using some spacecraft. So, here it is a story of transport from one place to another. So, can you tell us the distance, how far you travel from one city to another? The answer is very difficult. So, before answering that question, I will discuss about some measurements. For example, if you want to know the length, breadth and the height of your table or your study table at home, you will use your hand span, foot or the piece of string to know about the length, width or height of that table. But your hand span is not give the exact measurement as your mother's hand span give the exact measurement of that distance. So here it's difficult to know about the exact distance or the exact length of that particular instrument. So in ancient time, foot, string, hand span were used for know the length, breadth and the height of any object. So what is the actual mean of measurement? So measurement means the comparison of an unknown quantity with the known quantity. So that known quantity is called unit. So as you use your hand span, that is the distance from my little finger to thumb is this. So you use that hand span to know the distance of this face to this face. But your mother's hand or your hand is quite smaller or bigger than mine. So it is not the exact measurement which I can tell her or tell anybody. So here you have to know, so one part is that number or the other part of that measurement is unit. For example, if I see 1, 2, 3, 4, so here it is the 4 length of the one hand span, which means, or for example 12 length of your foot, it means the 4 is that number and the length of your hand span or foot is the unit. You can use also your foot. As I want to know the exact distance from this place to that, I will use my foot. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here the 4 foot were used to know the distance from this place to this place. But if you use your foot, the exact difference or the measurement is different. So here this is a need of some standard unit to know the measurement of the length. So next is standard unit of measurement. So in ancient time, length of foot, width of your finger or some other body parts were used to know the exact measurement of certain objects. So people of Indus Valley has the particular measurement at that time, so that they gave us many certain geometrical constructions of exact or a fixed geometrical constructions which are very useful for us, like pyramids, prisms, etc. So Romans used the pace or steps to know the measurements of the objects, like length, breadth and height of any object. The body parts were also used at that time. But in 1790, French created unit of measurement called metric system. So the first standard units were used at that time, or nowadays were using, it is metric system. So nowadays the standard unit to measure the length, breadth, height or to measure the certain exact measurement that a unit is used is called SI units, that is International System of Units. So what is International System of Unit? It is the unit of measurement used now, that is standard unit of measurement. For example, the SI unit of length. So length is used as meter. You have a scale at your home. You can see your scale has 1 to 15 divisions. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the divisions which are further divided also. For example, the SI unit of length is meter. We know 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. What does it mean? The 1 meter is divided into 100 subdivisions. What does it mean? It means if I take 0 here, if I take 1, this is 1 meter. Then 1 meter has 100 smart reasons. So that 100 smart reasons is 100 centimeter. So next is 1 centimeter. If I take from 0 to 1, that is 1 centimeter, it is divided into 10 reasons. That 10th reason is 1. That 1 centimeter is divided into 10 millimeter. So we can say that 1 centimeter is 10 millimeter. But we can calculate the length of cloth or your length of your height, how tall you are, by the unit, that is meter. But to measure the long distances, we use a unit that is called kilometer. So 1 kilometer is 1000 meter. So kilometer is a unit which is used to know the long distances. So here, you know, as your tailor is used an inch tape to know, that measuring tape to know the length of the cloth. A carpenter uses a scale, meter scale, to know the length of the door or the length of the window, etc. So farmer used the exact length, breadth and height of his field to know how much water is required in that field. So here it is very important to know the measurement, that is length, breadth, height of the any object, so that we can know their exact measurements. So the measurement of length can be studied in the unit, that is meter. So meter is subdivided into centimeter. So centimeter is divided into millimeter. So we can say that kilometer is the bigger unit. Next is meter, then next is centimeter, and last is millimeter. So millimeter is the smallest unit. So here in today's lecture we had read about the story of transport, how different vehicles came into existence and how the measurement of length takes place. Thank you.